praise the Lord and warmly welcome you to the worship room. Hallelujah. I want to warmly welcome you wherever you are joining from, and even with the weather patterns changing, even with the difficulty of all that's taking place around us, I want us to keep our hearts and minds focused to understand that He is with us. God is with us. His Holy Spirit is the one that's with us. So I pray right now together as we surrender our hearts, as we surrender our hearts and our minds in preparation to glorify the Father, that I pray that our attention, our attentiveness, our focus shall not be on one another, nor will your focus be to see me and when the screen is breaking up through the means and use of technology. Your heart will be aligned as a true believer of Christ, not all, but as a true believer of Christ, so that you will not be distracted for the slightest thing, as we see in the times of now. Focus not. That is why I always tell people, when they're listening to the word of the Lord, when they're focusing on the word of the Lord, when they're meditating on the word of the Lord, blind those eyes to look, so that you will be not watching me, but you will be focused to allow the Holy Spirit to settle in your hearts. So, loving Heavenly Father, we surrender this time. I pray, Father Lord, as you asked us to pray, so that we will not lean on one bit of our understanding, nor on the opinions of others, but only your opinion always matters, Father. So we thank you, Father, for all that you are. We thank you, Father, that you are good. And we want to give you the glory, all honor and all praise. And in Jesus' name, we give you the glory, we give you the honor. Hallelujah. Let's worship the Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Lord bless you and keep you, make his face shine upon and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Sing amen, O Lord.
Amen. 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 Amen.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations, and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations and the children and the children and the children and the children. May his presence go before you and behind you and beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you, he is with you.
Amen. Amen.
Worship the Lord. Hallelujah, Father. Jesus, it's all about your grace. Grace that flows like a river. We give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise, Father. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So sometimes, even with the bad weather, when we worship the Father, I want to just focus on what the Lord says. So let's worship. Hallelujah, Lord. We want to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. And even when the instruments stop, even when everything else stops, Father, we want to focus on you, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let's just sing without the instruments, focusing not on what happens out there. Hallelujah, Jesus. Grace that flows like a river, washing over me. Fount of heaven, lover of Christ, overflowing me. Grace that flows like river washing over me. Fount of heaven, lover of Christ, overflowing me. Thank you, Jesus. You set me free. You set me free. Christ, my Savior, you rescued me. Yes, Lord. Hallelujah, Jesus. Sing grace. Grace that flows like a river, washing over me. Fount of heaven, lover of Christ, washing over me. Thank you, Jesus. You rescued me. Christ, my Savior, you rescued me. Thank you, Jesus. You set me free. Christ, my Savior. Christ, my Savior, you rescued me. You rescued me. Hallelujah. Take this life delivered. Take this life delivered. Vessel of your love, wholly now devoted. Holy now devoted to see your kingdom come. Thank you, Jesus. You rescued me. Christ, my Savior, you set me free. Sing, you've given me life, you've opened my eyes. You have given me life, you have opened my eyes. I love you, Lord, I love you, Lord. You have entered my heart. You have set me apart. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus, you set me free. Christ, my Savior, you rescued me. Hallelujah, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Hallelujah, Father. Beyond all technical difficulties, Father, that we may appear transparent, Father, that when things happen surrounding us, we will not put something in front, but we will stand steadfast to worship you. Sometimes, even in the world in these last days, even when we rely on things, let us not lean on our own understanding, that when technology fails, it will fail. We will not lean to understand why, but we will still stand focused, connected in your spirit, to worship in spirit and in truth, so that when performance-oriented focus happens out there, we will not partake nor embrace in those atmospheres. Our focus is not for the attention of people. Our focus is for the glory of you, Jesus. Let's just worship the Father, even as there is bad weather out there, even as systems are slowing down, even as the connections are slowing down. Let us keep our focus and our attention so that we will not get comfortable through smooth sailing live streams and smooth sailing messages to receive all that the Lord has. Hallelujah. Oh Lord Jesus, we give you the glory. Oh Lord, you're beautiful. Your face is all I seek. For when your eyes are on this child, your grace abounds to me. You Lord, you're beautiful. Your face is all I see. And when your eyes are on this child, your grace abounds to me. I want to take your word and shine it all around. But first help me just to live it, Lord. And when I'm doing well, help me to never seek a crown, for my reward is giving glory to you. Oh Lord, please light the fire that once but bright and clear. Replace the lamp of my first love that burns with holy fear. I want to take your word and shine it all around. But first help me just to live it, Lord. And when I am doing well, help me to never seek a crown, for my reward is giving glory to you. Oh Lord, you're beautiful. Your face is all I seek. For when your eyes are on this child, your grace abounds to me. Your grace abounds to me. Your grace
abounds to me.
Hallelujah, Lord. We give you all the glory, all honor, all praise. In Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Warmly welcome to the worship room. It's been a blessed time amidst the chaos, I would like to say. Because sometimes when certain things happen right in front of us, technology is something that many, all of us rely on. But I want to tell you that beyond all times, not to focus on technology, because technology can always crash. Technology will crash. Technology is always limited, no matter how far human endeavor attempts to achieve even the fastest processing speed of a processor in technology. When weather patterns, things happen, many things can happen around us, but when technology fails, where does our hope lie on? Where is our hope resting on? Where is our faith constantly on? Mine has always been that when I worship, there have been occasions, even on a live worship, which even this is, but even on a platform, whatever the platform may be, wherever I may gather to glorify my Heavenly Father, wherever it may be, I've always, constantly stood by faith that even when the instruments surrounding me may suddenly crash or when the power goes off, I've always been led to just be able to drop it and to be able to just worship the Lord. You know, when we first started worshiping as kids, even where I gained my foundation in the word of the Lord was, we didn't have many instruments around us. We just had a tambourine and we had a few things, but it is those that stayed with us and taught us to always say, put aside the sounds of the gong and the sounds of everything else so that we have a mouth to worship with. We have two hands to clap and project that to the Lord, so that when we worship the Lord in spirit and in truth, we will not get caught in the times of the entertainment atmosphere, but we will get caught in the times of glorifying the Father. Because today, as the title suggests, even as I share God's word, I pray that the Lord will guide, that the Lord will open up our eyes, that we will stand firm, because we go by truth and not by facts. So, loving Heavenly Father, once again, I surrender this time which belongs to you Every second of every day of our lives is not by our agenda, not according to our calendar. That I pray, trusting and believing that our agendas, that the diaries we jot down and plan our plans will be muddled up, completely torn apart, so that we will come into alignment of your plan and purpose. So that we who are running around doing many things, Father, that we will be slowed down so much that we will be in attention to just hear your word. Even when there are chaotic times happening around us, we will not budge, not be bothered by the opinions of the atmosphere that surrounds the world, but we will be surrounded by the atmosphere of your Holy Spirit. So, Father, in Jesus' name, we surrender it all. Have your way. Amen. Amen. So I'm really excited to share this with you, because even as I was praying all week and praying over the last few days, the Lord really shared this through his Holy Spirit to say, in times of uncertainty right now, what do we stand on? There are times of hopelessness, then when suddenly the shift or tides change according to favor of people, there's all of a sudden praise and joy, and then there's chaos and there's so much of things happening. But Jesus said that we are to stand by truth and not the facts, not by what we see. See, Jesus said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. You see, Jesus, let's read this together. In John 14, verses 5 to 7, it says, the Lord said to Thomas, we do not know where you are going, so how can we know the way? Jesus answered, I am, that is Jesus, not me, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father, the Heavenly Father, except through me, meaning Jesus. Verse 7 continues on to say, if you had known me, that is known Jesus, you would know my Father as well, know God as well. From now on, you do know him and have seen him. Have you seen Jesus? Have you heard his voice? Do you spend time to hear his voice? You know, 2 weeks ago, 3 weeks ago, I spoke on actually spending time in his presence. Not one moment, but it has to be 24 hours of the day in order to hear his audible voice. In order to hear his voice, you can't be surrounded by other voices. You can't be surrounded by many, many things. Today I'm in a season where even in the midst of others, or even in the midst of conversations, God has developed my character to be able to tune my ears off, that things will go in and come out, that my attention is only to focus on what God says and to do what God says, and everything else gets filtered out, and the only things that remain is only what God has said. We need to come into that atmosphere. We need to develop it. We can't develop it by keeping one foot here and one foot there. We need to let go and just release the attachments, because people have attached themselves, and these are the believers, not even the unbelievers, the believers of God's word. But whilst believing God's word, you can't believe in what others also believe. You need to separate yourself. Hallelujah. Let's continue to read on what John chapter 1 verse 4 says, in him was life, and that life was the light of men. Because John 1:14 says, the word became flesh and made his dwelling amongst, back then them, amongst us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son from the Father, full of grace and full of truth. Because John 1 chapter 17 continues on to say, for the law was given through Moses, grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. See, there were people even in the Old Testament times where they were focused on the individual people. Even when the laws were passed, God passed the laws through Moses, their focus was Moses, not God's word. Today, many are carrying God's word. That's why I always tell people, when you're sharing God's word, don't label it to you. Don't pin it to you. But know that we are vessels for God to use us. There's no crown over our heads. There's no throne that we are sitting on. There's only one throne, and the rightful heir to the throne is on that throne, and that's God. Jesus is to his right hand. We are his children. We have inherited his name, but don't ever forget who God is. Don't forget who's on the throne. We will not be on the throne. God is God, who is the same yesterday, today, and forevermore. When you're spirit-led, you need to understand that we are spirit beings. When we carry forth his word, when Moses carried forth that message down, most people focused on, got to understand. Don't focus on the people, but focus on God's word. Focus our eyes, not on anyone else. Because in John verse chapter 10 verse 9 says, I am the gate. If anyone enters through me, not anyone else, he will be saved. He will come in and go out and find pasture. Pasture. Don't mistake the word. Because in John 11 verse 25 says, Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, we've heard this so many times, will live even though he dies. We're on this earth. God knows the numbers of our days on this earth, the very breath in our lungs. Some people declare, you know, I've reached a certain age. I've lived my life. Really? Are you sure? Sometimes when I hear these comments, I've come into that state where even though I'm in the midst of conversations, I don't partake. Many think I partake, I don't. I've gained the maturity of Christ that constantly, when eyebrows go up, when eyes go rolling, it doesn't bother me. I want you to do the very same, to trust only in what God's word says and converse in the same manner. But you can't do it overnight. You need to develop it so that when you keep speaking it, when you keep speaking it, when you keep muttering and uttering as God said for us, it will become a natural. Because when we believe in him, we will have everlasting life. Trust and believe that our days are numbered constantly. See, Jesus comforted his disciples. I want to share with you, turn to John chapter 14 in your Bibles. John chapter 14 in your Bibles. Hallelujah. See, from verse 1 we will read through to say, do not let your hearts be troubled, afraid, or cowardly. Believe, how? Confidently in God and trust in him. Have faith. Hold on to it. Rely on it. Keep going and believe also in me, Jesus says. In verse 2, in my Father's house are many dwelling places. Beyond the songs we sing of dwelling places. If it were not so, I would have told you. Because I'm going there to prepare a place for you, you and I. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and I will take you to myself, so that where I am, you may be also. In verse 4, and meaning to the place where I am going, Jesus, you know the way. Because if you know the way, the truth, and the life, you will be set free. Thomas in the Bible says, Thomas said to Jesus, Lord, we do not know where we are going. So how can we know the way? Many of us do that. In even 2,000 plus years later, even after Jesus taught it. But Jesus very gently says, Jesus said to him, I am the only way to God and the real truth and the real life. No one comes to the Father but through me. Hallelujah. We saw how Jesus comforted his disciples. He didn't comfort the disciples with, you know, just an opinion, but he gave the word, for he is the word. He didn't just put on some other words of comfort and just so that they may just rely on that. No, he gave them truth, the truth nuggets of life to live by, so that he showed them that this is how it's going to be. And then he continues on to show the oneness of Jesus to the Father. If you had really known me, in verse 7 of chapter 14, John chapter 14, you would also have known my Father from now on. From now on, you know him and have seen him. Philip said to him, Lord, show us the Father and then we will be satisfied. But Jesus, like earlier, said to Philip, like he said to Thomas, have I been with you for so long a time and you do not know me yet, Philip, nor recognize clearly who I am? Anyone who has seen me has seen the Father. How can you say, show us the Father? Do you not believe that I am the Father and the Father is in me? The words I say to you, I do not say on my own initiative or authority, but the Father abiding continually in me does his works, his attesting miracles and acting of power. See how then Jesus, being the Son of the Father, yet God Almighty, was on this earth, had all the power, yet he was abiding by the Father. He was abiding by the Word. He did everything in a systematic way to the kingdom purpose. You see, many people ask, so if Jesus was God, why didn't he? That is a mindset of a fallen world. That is a mindset of human development. When we are born into this earth, what are we influenced by? Are we surrounded by those who are constantly praying, constantly declaring Jesus, constantly seeing worship happening around us? If that's so, my goodness, fantastic. But is it? No. We're surrounded by people all on a journey, searching for answers, seeking for answers, going through hills and valley experiences, sick one day, healed one day, sick for a month, not sick for a month, fantastic in one area of their life, and so on and so forth. But what you got to understand is, when you come into accepting the Father, when you come into accepting Jesus, when you come into connection of the Holy Spirit, when you trust and believe in God's word, you are set free no longer to think of the way of all that surrounds you, so that you can be a vessel when you know the truth to be set free, not just for yourself. You weren't set free, by the way, in the kingdom of heaven on this earth. Our setting free was not for us. We're set free so that we can be a vessel for God to be able to use us, to work through us, to set others free. That is the purpose. Our purpose is not, hallelujah, we are set free, and then go on your own path, and at the same time, selectively, you know, as and when. No. No. Goodness, no. Because in verse 11, it says, believe me that I am in the Father and the Father is in me. Otherwise, believe me because of the very works themselves which you have witnessed. I assure you, Jesus says, and most solemnly say to you, anyone who believes in me as one's Savior, beg your pardon, will also do the things that I do. And he will do even greater things. I want you not to settle there. That these in extent and outreach, because I am going to the Father. And I will do whatever you ask in my name as my representative. Not Jesus, but as Jesus' representative. This I will do so that the Father may be glorified. We will not be recognized and glorified and celebrated in the Son. If you ask me anything in my name, as my representative, I will do it. Verse 15 of John 14 says, if you love me, really love me, you will keep and obey my commandments. How amazing is that? See, when God gives us that opportunity to do greater things in the name of Jesus, today we've seen people have made courses, seminars, programs of, you know, breakthrough, Holy Spirit impartation, and so on and so forth. And it's become like programs and clubs and so many things. And, you know, through the seasons, I used to witness this, observe this, sometimes have even gone to some of these things. But whenever I was in the midst of this one human being was always in commune and connection to the Father, so that even if I was sitting, taking notes, my ears were opened. And I pray that your ears will be opened as well, wherever you are, wherever you go. Don't just buy into things. Keep the word of the Lord at hand, but don't just keep the Lord at the hand. It's better on a shelf. You need to open it. You need to read it. You need to meditate in it. You need to ask the Holy Spirit to guide you so that you will understand what the Lord has said and what someone else says that the Lord has said. Today, when I share this is not Angelo's version of what the Lord said. This is directly word to word of what the Lord has said. No opinions. My opinions, as I always make sure I say it on the live stream, died the day that I accepted Christ. To understand the role of the Spirit in John 14, 16 says, and I will ask the Father, and he will give you another helper, which I myself has always relied on, who has been a comforter, an advocate, an intercessor, a counselor, strengthener, standby, and always standing by, to be with you forever. Who is that? Do you know who that is? Sometimes we give prominence to God Almighty, Yahweh, Jesus Christ Almighty, Jesus Christ of Nazareth, understanding all that. But understand, it is the three who are one, and the third is the Holy Spirit. The Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive and take it to its heart, because it does not see him and know him. You see? But you know him because what? He, the Holy Spirit, remains with you continually and be with you, be within you. How do we know that? Because Jesus said so. If you doubt it, that's your doubt that's allowing you to rise within you. Because Jesus left the Holy Spirit for us. For those that believe, He will reveal Himself. People are walking by sight, not by faith. That's why I titled it to say today, you know, we go by truth. You see, we stand by truth. We stand by faith, not by what surrounds us. In verse 18, Jesus said, I will not leave you as orphans. He never will forsake us, nor will He abandon us. Comfortless, bereaved and helpless, I will come back to you. Jesus will return to us one day. After a little while, the world will no longer see me. That was when He was leaving. But you will see me because I live. You will live also because He lives. We can face tomorrow. We sing these hymnals. We partake when others lead and we sing these things. But I encourage you in this new season, whenever you hear a hymnal, a praise song, a worship song, take away the titles. Take away who's singing it. Focus not on the voice. Oh, that's a beautiful voice. You've lost the plot. Because your mind, the upbringing from childhood is how people have perceived. This is how music is. This is how a sermon is. This is how this is. And you have compartmentalized apart from what God said. For me, I took from that infancy to everything. And I took it in one bunch, crunched it up, and out the window it went. It was a renewal, so that it was a complete flush of everything that I had learned. I had to unlearn to learn. You see? You got to understand that that was one of the foundations that we received when we were little, coming to Christ. But many don't do that anymore. You cannot just bring the baggage in and be accepted and welcome. No, you can't. That is why there's no change. That is why there's no development. On that day, Jesus says in verse 20, when that time comes, you will know for yourselves that I am in my Father, and you are in me, and I am in you. The person who has my commandments and keeps them is the one who really loves me. And whoever really loves me will be loved by my Father. And I will love him and reveal myself to him, to you and I. I will make myself real to him. You see? How powerful it is. It goes on to say, verse 22, this is interesting. Judas, not Iscariot, asked him, Lord, what has happened that you are going to reveal yourself to us and not to the world? Many people ask this. If God is God, why is He not revealing Himself to the world? In such chaotic times today, 2,000 plus years later. But Jesus answered, this is so relevant in verse 23. If anyone really loves me, he will keep my word. Keep Jesus' teaching. Is the world doing that right now collectively? Forget the world. Is the church doing that? You see, you can have many, many places, but is it in one accord? Is it one word? Is it one truth? Is it one banner that is Jesus? Is it one focus? Is it in one accord? Until that happens, it cannot spread to the four corners of the world. Because what's being spread to the four corners of the world is danger. Opinions. That is why there's so many viewpoints, different belief systems within the body of Christ. You see? But Jesus said in verse 24, one who does not really love me does not keep my words. And the word, that is the teaching, which you hear is not mine, but is the Father's who sent me. You got to understand. I have told you these things while I am still with you. That is when Jesus was with us. But the Helper, that is the Holy Spirit, the Comforter, Advocate, Intercessor, our Counselor, Strengthener, the Holy Spirit, whom the Father will send in my name, that is in the name of Jesus, to represent Jesus and act on Jesus' behalf, he will teach you all things. He will teach us all things, not some things. All things. And he will help you remember what? Everything I have told you. You see, when Jesus was leaving, the disciples were so worried. They were so worried. Everything that Jesus would have, it's like, you know, when you're in a class and you're learning something and suddenly that teacher is about to go and you start panic, failing to realize that you didn't learn for the teacher's sake, you learned it so that it's within you and so that you can rise and be able to share that. But some on this earth, when you're being taught, the moment something happens, it all goes out. And that was happening to the disciples because they were not standing by faith. They weren't listening to what Jesus was saying. The focus is, oh, Master, you're leaving. And everything that Jesus was teaching was suddenly out the window, you see. But Jesus said this because he already knew that the disciples were going to do this. And he will help you remember everything that I have told you, because human beings most of the time cannot remember. Some declare that over their lives. Now for me, I have been given a photographic memory, and that again I stand by his grace to say it's by his grace, thankfulness for his grace and his mercy, that I remember that everything remains within me, that I thank God that I don't forget. I don't forget. And God has kept it always intact so that everything that needs to remain remains, and everything that does not need to gets filtered out. Jesus said, "Peace I will leave with you. My perfect peace I give to you. Not as the world gives do I give to you." This world is not aligned to the kingdom of heaven. That's why when we pray the Lord's Prayer, not just reciting it, on earth as it is in heaven. We don't say on heaven as it is on earth. Good Lord forbid that. Heaven is settled. Everything is settled in heaven. There is no opinions, this one, that one, left, right. No, it's one focus, God. Worship, God. Focus, God. Some in this movement of free movement of belief systems in the body of Christ have said, because they're teaching this kind of stuff. You know, if we were just going to heaven and if we were just going to worship the Lord all day long. No, there's no day long. It's eternal. You know, that'll be a bit boring. Why? Because your mindset thinks on earth that'll be very boring. So if I go to heaven, that's going to be boring. Sometimes when I used to surround myself with people like this who used to declare this, my nature used to be, I used to not stand and project words towards them, but I used to just silently observe these things and say, "Lord, mute those tongues, renew their faith system." For me, if I had the option, because on this earth I've adapted to, you know, watching football, little likes and dislikes, food, favorite foods, favorite this and favorite that. But because he's given me discernment, trust me, even the best football game that I could be watching, or the best food that I could be eating, or I could be doing this or that, or composing or whatever, I could just drop it in a heartbeat. I could just drop it in a heartbeat without question and spend time in his presence. But we have entertained something so different over the last few decades that the body of Christ has, it's like, forget believing in evolution. They've evolved into something else, which is dangerous. Get rid of this, I am bored. Get rid of this, oh, I'm so lonely. Get rid of all that nonsense and focus so that you can be strengthened to know if God is with you, you can't be. If God has set you free, you can't be. If He is truly alive and He is with you, all those other things, you can't be. You cannot be. You see? Because Jesus said, let my perfect peace calm you in every circumstance and give you courage and strength for every challenge we face. Verse 28 says, you heard me tell you, I'm going away and I'm coming back to you. If you really loved me, you would have rejoiced, not panicked. You would have rejoiced. Because I am going back to the Heavenly Father where He ought to be. For the Father is greater than I, Jesus said. I have told you now before it happens in verse 29, chapter 4 of John, for those just joining, so that when it does take place, you may believe and have faith in me. I will not speak with you much longer, Jesus said. For the ruler of the world, right now, Satan is coming. Some don't believe in this stuff. It's like heaven. That also they don't tend to believe. We're on this earth. We see everything. That's all that I can see. So that's all I believe. Well, hell, I mean, yeah. And because, see, back in the day when we were set forth with the word and those teaching it, we had the reverent fear of the Lord. So we had an attentive span to focus. How can you focus when you have this, that, and the other, and this and that? For me, it's all blocked off, switched off. Nothing. No distractions. You can't be distracted. Because but so the world may know without any doubt, Jesus said, that I love the Father. I do exactly as the Father has commanded me and act in full agreement with Him. Let's get up. Let us go from here. Understand. He is the way, the truth, and the life. See, Jesus constantly kept teaching us, I want you to know. Not just the disciples, but it's through His word and teachings, constantly knowing that it would be spread through the nations to this day, so that we will be reminded by the very Holy Spirit who was placed within us to be a guide and a reminder to know that faith is a substance. What? I remember when I was doing this Operation Solid Lives Beyond the Program. Many of us had to remind ourselves and memorize certain things per week, and it used to seep into our hearts and then tested, and suddenly you're trying to figure out. But when you actually start to do it with the guidance of the Holy Spirit and you understand that when faith is a substance of things hoped for, even before that, like I knew, all what I see is not what I believe in. I stand by faith to know the evidence of things not seen. You see? The triumphs of faith. We need to understand the triumphs of faith. What is that? Hebrews chapter 11, verse 1. Now faith is the assurance, that is the confirmation, of things hoped for, that is divinely, there's a guarantee, and the evidence of things not seen, that means the conviction of their reality. Faith comprehends as fact what cannot be experienced by the physical senses. I believe it was last week I was telling, and the week before, because the Holy Spirit just, even when I'm sharing these, it's not a distraction, but He says it, to say that for people, it's like seeing is believing. I need to hear It's like, you know, with the sense of hearing, I need to touch to feel. I need to be able to taste, to understand, to know that it's good. I need to smell, to identify, and so on and so on and so forth. See, we may not see the evidence yet, but what we can see is what God has said through His Word. We live in times of uncertainty, but be certain of this, of what God has said. We're living in uncertain times because we've surrounded ourselves with uncertainty. Whilst there's chaos of a pandemic that started end of last year, coming upon our 1 year, for most people, instead of praying, believing, trusting, steadfast, not just going on fasts, standing steadfast, trusting the Lord, just going on a fast is not going to do anything. That ritualistic, religious-minded nonsense that has infested, get rid of it. It's not Jesus, I'm sorry to say. You need to renew your mind. Be steadfast, pray. Trusting the Lord. Trust the Lord your God. By faith we understand. By faith we understand. In Hebrews 11 verse 3 says, by faith we understand that the evidence was formed at God's command, so that what is seen was not made out of what is visible. That what was visible. We live in uncertain times whilst the pandemic is on. Some are comparing to the other viruses, the Ebola viruses, and all the other things have taken place in the years gone by. So now we will settle into this and c'est la vie, que sera, sera, whatever may be, may be. That to me personally, deviating from the word of the Lord, is mumbo jumbo. It's nonsense. Absolute nonsense. Where does it come from? Jesus? Good Lord, no. God Almighty? Heaven forbid. The Holy Spirit led? Never. Where does it come from? Culture. Surrounding ourselves with those that do not know God's word. Watching what? What the Lord's word says? No. Watching what society has perceived. And what society is projecting through social media, text messages, social gossip. For me, there was a time when I used to just silence the forwards that were constantly coming. Now, I just click, 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 click. One button. Delete, 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 flushed. Don't entertain. Don't even entertain and then delete and then feel guilt. No, you can't. If you are of Him, you're set free. You can't go into guilt. Because when we stand by faith, we understand that the evidence was formed of whose command? God's command. So that what is seen was not made out of what was visible. Today the world is at a crossroad. Even if the screen is freezing for you whilst you're watching the internet, don't allow the mind to get distracted. Listen to the voice. I actually tell the Lord, even if my face gets blocked off, listen to the word. You're not here to watch me. Never watch someone else. Keep your eyes on Jesus. Be led by the Holy Spirit. Today the world is at a crossroads of making the right choices, right decisions. That may be crucial according to God's word. And then there is also the other way. That is according to how the world wants it to be. For a better way of life. Better acceptance of things. In equality and so on and so forth. In times where God places those to abide and stand by God's word. Catch this. Beyond the humor that's going surrounding us. Amidst what the world may think, the world would mock and despise. Even in times of chaos, whilst the pandemic is on, political agendas are happening. In God's word, according to the book of Amos, chapter 5 verse 10 says, "You hate the one who reproves in court and despise him who tells the truth." God has called us above all things to acknowledge God before the whole world and never be shy, never be ashamed or back down feeling ashamed, for in the book of Matthew it is written, which we will read together, chapter 10 verse 32 of Matthew, chapter 10 verse 32, "Whoever acknowledges me before men, I will also acknowledge him before my Father in heaven. For everything on this earth that is leftist," to the left, not just the left, "and that comes against him and his word eventually shall be brought to justice by God in that time. And for those that believe and stand abiding by God's word alone and in Christ alone, you shall stand. Then stand firm, never shaking with what's taking place out there right now. But know God is in full control and allows things to happen." In the book of Ecclesiastes, chapter 10, verse 2, "The heart of the wise inclines to the right," God's word, "but the heart of the fool to the left." God says the heart of the wise is a conservative in those who walks with the word of God, keeps the word of God, stands firm on the word of the Lord, and meditates in his word. Those who go against the heart of the Father are the fools who go to the left. God, no one else, people can say, but God calls them fools. See, as a child of God, and I'm encouraged and led to tell you, you cannot have a mind of your own. Already there's eyes rolling. You cannot have a mind of your own with your own ideas, like what is being taught in this fallen world and modern movements that share his word in the last days. Jesus warns us of such things taking place and to take heed, to take guard, putting on the whole armor of the Lord. You are not called to live a balanced, compromised life, to allow everything out there, to kind of badagandify and take the whole buffet and put it on your plate. No. Compromised life, to allow everything that's out there, to let in everything which was against God's word and God's system that sadly has crept into the faith system of God's houses around the world, not just one place. Why is this, you may ask? Why is this? Because today we live in a compromised, constantly compromised, failing to realize the sacrifice Jesus Christ of Nazareth paid heavily so that we will abide by the law of one word, one system, not that of our own, not of our own opinions, leaning towards our own understandings and the understandings of those who think they know and when is being taught. You blindly bought into the misleading, for in the end, it's not the opinions of what you or anyone else thought, but one, his truth shall set us free. No one else's truth. Were you ever set by anyone else's truth? And did you go and praise them? I would ask you to not feel guilt, but get rid of that thought. and be set free by Jesus. If ever you came to Christ through someone else and you were praising that, good Lord, you've lost the plot. You've lost it. That is why whenever I share the word, and even if I'm sharing with someone else, first thing that I do in prayer is we pray together. We listen to what the Lord's Holy Spirit says to us. Even when I'm sharing, don't listen to my voice. Don't look at my face. Don't listen to my voice. Don't be led by me, but led by the Holy Spirit. We do this together, constantly glorifying God, constantly thanking Jesus, constantly be leading by Jesus, the Holy Spirit, I beg your pardon. And not being afraid to say it. You don't walk by faith and walk by shyness, you know. You can't. I hear leaders say this, you know, I'm a bit shy to do this, Sunny, sir. I'm like, this is not about us. This is not about us. When we stand to follow Christ all the way, not halfway, we're not out there to go to constantly teach blindly, misleading. For in the end, it's not opinions of what others or anyone else says. For it's His truth that shall set us free. That shall set us free. And for that to happen, you need to be set free to stand by His word. To be led by the Holy Spirit. To follow. Who? Follow Christ. All the way, not halfway. We're followers of Christ. Friends. Family. We're not followers of the body of Christ. Let me remind you, no matter who says it, we are followers of Christ Jesus all the way to the very end. Many will mock you, Jesus said. Many will despise you, but get this. I love this part. We're coming to a close, but don't wait for the close. Many will mock you, many will despise you, many will remove you from their vicinity, but you were never to form yourselves into the vicinity of others, but surround yourself only with those that stand by faith and not by sight, and pray diligently for those that do not see, surrendering them to the Lord, but never allowing your mind to settle in their midst. John 15, chapter 18. If the world hates you, what does Jesus say? I love this. Keep in mind that it hated me first. In verse 19, if you belonged to the world would love you as its own and would treat you with affection, but you are not of the world. You no longer belong to it. But I have chosen you out of the world, and because of this, the world hates you. Understand, we're not of this world. We're in this world, we're not of it. We will walk and have favor of God. We will walk and have His grace. It is by His mercies that we breathe and live again. Hallelujah. By the sacrifice of Jesus. In Proverbs, in the book of Proverbs 21:21, he who pursues righteousness and love finds life, prosperity, and honor. And none of this is according to the honor and no prosperity that the world seeks, by the way, just to remind you. Don't seek prosperity of what the world speaks of. Jesus said to him, I'm the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father but by me. See, as the title, when I said it, stand firm. For we go by truth and not by facts. I'm going to break this down as we conclude. I want you to catch this to the end and don't log off. What did Jesus say when he said, I am the way? Turn to John chapter 10, verse 9. Jesus said, I am the way. In verse 9 of chapter 10 says, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved and shall go in and out and find pasture. In Isaiah chapter 35, verse 8 to 9. Hallelujah. It says, "And an highway shall be there, and a way, and it shall be called the way of holiness. The unclean shall not pass over it, but it shall be for those, the wayfaring men, though fools shall not err therein." In Matthew chapter 11 verse 27 says, "All things are delivered unto me of my Father, and no man knows the Son but the Father, neither knows any man the Father save the Son, and he to whomever, whomsoever the Son will reveal him." As we said, "I am the way," Jesus said, "and the truth." Now let's see what the truth says. John chapter 1, 14 and 17. "And the Word was made flesh and dwelt among us, and we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten one of the Father, full of grace and truth." John 8, chapter 32 says, "And you shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free," or set you free. John 15, verse 1, "I am the true vine, and my Father is the," what? "Husbandman." What is a husbandman? See, Jesus compared God to the husbandman in John 15, verses 1 to 2. "I am the true vine, and my Father is the husbandman." I want you to understand this before I continue. "Every branch in me that bears not fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he purges it, that it may bring forth more fruit." A good husbandman works the earth, cultivates his plants, and naturally expects them to produce fruit commensurate with the amount of effort he has invested in them. Our Heavenly Father, you have to understand, the divine husbandman, seeks to produce fruit through us as we abide in Christ. See, we spoke of "I'm the way," Jesus said, "I'm the truth." Now let's look at "I'm the life." "I'm the way, the truth, and the life." Hallelujah. John 14, verse 19. "Yet a little while, and the world will see me no longer, but you see me, because I live, you will live also." John 1, verse 4. "In him was life, and the life was the light of men." For in John 5, verse 21, 25 through 29 says, "For as the Father raised up the dead and quickens them, even so the Son quickeneth whom he will." Oh, hallelujah. And finally, "No one comes to the Father but through me." In John 10, 7 to 9 says, "Then said Jesus to them again, Verily, 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 I say to you, I am the door of the sheep." Because in Acts chapter 4, verse 12 continues to say, "Neither is there salvation in any other." You can't find salvation in anyone else on this earth. Never, never. "For there is none other name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved." You cannot be saved by anyone, no matter who comes, because in the last days, they will come. They will come. They will come with names. They will come with titles. They will come with badges. They will come with projections. Walk away. Walk away. Walk away. Do not even stay to listen. I tell you, don't stay to listen. Because we live in times where the body of Christ, let me try it and see. Let me just try to listen. I am strong enough. I can discern it. You can't. You do things on your own and you will fail. Which is why you need the guidance of the Holy Spirit. You need Jesus. None else. And surround yourself to strengthen yourself with like-minded who think alike. You can't think alike if you don't spend time with God's Word. Because in conclusion, I want to tell you, in Numbers chapter 6, verses 24 to 26. The Lord bless you and keep you, protect you, sustain you and guard you. The Lord make His face shine upon you, as we sang earlier, with favor, and be gracious to you, surrounding you with loving kindness. The Lord lift up His countenance, face upon you with divine approval and give you peace, a tranquil heart and life. Hallelujah. See, I want to encourage you today, because when we started with a moment of, for me, I didn't panic. The Holy Spirit was with me, so even when those things were happening, I didn't go this and that. I just worshiped the Lord. If you were focused only on me, trust me, you would have just been distracted. My face would have been, you know, all sorts of things were happening with the screen, and the thunders were rumbling, rains were coming down. Rain has ceased. There's no more thunder. Because we stayed focused. Sometimes things will start to shake at the start, and there will be a shaking, there will be distracting things that will happen. But if you could just allow yourself, even if someone beside you was getting distracted, your journey is your own. God brought you onto this earth alone, you will be going alone. But when God puts you in the midst of those surrounding you, whilst praying for them, stand steadfast. Don't be dragged into unbelief. Don't be dragged into doubt. Don't be dragged into opinion. Don't be dragged into negative thinking. Don't be dragged into conversations of nothing but of the Lord. Don't be dragged into everything else that is on the left. Don't be dragged into unwanted jibber jabber. But stand steadfast. Stand steadfast. Stand focused. You're a child of God. I'm encouraged to tell you today, just as God gave me a passion to speak, to preach beyond worshiping Him, in spirit and in truth, not with a backing of labels or recognition, but so that when I stood to put aside all that and tear down the labels, it was by His favor and grace that surrounds me constantly, with His angels standing to guard me wherever I am. And I share that with you to say, there is hope. There is hope in a world that is falling apart. And that hope is through Christ Jesus. And that He is forever with you. In a world filled with chaos, stand firm, I tell you, because I am not the one who said it. Jesus did. Stand firm. Stand firm. Constantly stand firm. Because He is forever with you. He is forever with you. I tell you, do not be that fool that God mentioned in His word by straying to the left but stand steadfast and turn your eyes upon Jesus. Look full upon his face, for all the things of this world shall soon fall apart, shall go weary and dim, and pass away, for his light shall shine down, his glory will arise, and his grace shall fall over this earth once more. Much is to come, much is to happen, for the victory is only in Christ Jesus, no one else. Know that when we trust and obey him and stand by his word in Christ alone, we are to stand not on facts and figures, for we are to stand by truth, and that truth is through his word and what his word clearly says. So I tell you, may his shalom settle. May his shalom peace settle with you today. And until we meet again, may his grace abide. May the grace of our loving Heavenly Father rest and abide in you and your household. And the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be our constant guide when we constantly seek him. Seek his face. Seek him first. Peace that passeth all understanding. Through this journey every day, walk without anxiousness, walk without worry, walk without doubt, walk when suddenly the news says something. I'm not asking you to pretend. They said it. That's what the world says. Worry yourself not. You're meant to have a kingdom mind. To know a kingdom mind, you need to know the difference between the kingdom of heaven and the kingdom down here. And we are to be agents to pull down the atmosphere of heaven, because we are pillars placed so that through that vessel a gateway is open, not Hollywood gateways, so that he will truly project down that atmosphere through us as vessels to release it out. So let's pray right now and surrender it all to him, so that we will stand. I want you to declare this. I stand firm from now on, for I will go by truth. I will stand by truth, no longer by facts, no longer to stand in compromise. No matter who else does it, I will not. I will stand by faith, I will stand by truth, and not by what the facts tell me. Loving Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for yet another day that you have made, and we shall rejoice constantly to give you the glory, the honor, and the praise. We thank you, Abba Father, thank you, Lord, that you are with us through your Holy Spirit, Jesus, that you left us, because we believe that you are up there, the right hand of the Father, and we will not compromise to reason, to wonder, to doubt, to share opinions, because we live in times where each believer is, I'm just sharing my opinion, it's okay, give me your opinion, that opinion. We rebuke it. We renounce it through an announcement, and to say, Father, let your opinion settle down on this earth. We pray for a steadfastness of your peace in our hearts and our lives. Tear down the walls, that the banner of Jesus will be always with us. The only name above every other name that is up. So that we will be agents of change. Not focusing on the name of agents, but we will be servants, vessels called for a purpose to glorify you. We give you all the glory, the honor, and the praise, Lord, trusting and believing. We pray for every nation out there, Father. We pray for the nations going through turmoil right now. We pray, Father, for the nations that have gone through their elections. We pray for our very own nations, Father. We pray for everything that is happening, Father. Even things that have happened that you've allowed things to happen. In your time, let your will be done. Let your kingdom come down, Father, so that, Father, our eyes will be opened. Our hearts shall be in alignment to you and your heart. That our minds will be renewed with a total renewal of a mindset no longer that is of this earth. And our spirit beings will rise by faith every day till you come back or you call us to be with you. Help that to be the atmosphere of our households. When the forwards and the social media comes, help us to be quick to delete it if it doesn't apply to your word. Help us not to forward it to another innocent life, but prevent these fingers from even reading it. When we know where the source of who sends those messages, delete it in Jesus' name, so that we will be focused in a completely new way, Father. No longer being in an atmosphere of the same old, same old. So, Father, we surrender it all into your hands, trusting and believing that your plans and purposes are coming to pass. And until we meet again, we will continue to stay steadfast in the presence of your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Hallelujah. And may God bless you, and may His Holy Spirit guide you all the way. Until we meet again, I'm Angelo from the worship room. May you be blessed from where you are, so that you can carry forth God's word and share it to those around you. Carry forth His word. Stand firm, no longer by facts and figures, but we stand by truth and by faith. In Jesus' name, shalom.